Think about a world without Excel. That's just impossible for me. That's what Microsoft CEO Satya Nadella said back in 2016. Now, over the last 30 years, Excel's become the professional standard in offices across the globe. Many companies rely on it to carry out their day-to-day business. That's why basic Excel skills is a mandatory requirement for most office-based professionals today. Advanced Excel skills can get you a promotion. Some jobs even require advanced Excel skills to begin with. Potential employers also want to make sure that you have the right Excel skills to get the job done. That's why they routinely ask Excel questions during the interview process. Now, depending on the job, the questions will vary. Here's a list of the top 5 Excel questions asked at interviews. Make sure you know these before you go to your next interview. Now, I also have some news to share. I'm going to do that at the end of the video, so stay tuned for that. Question number 1. What is the syntax of the VLOOKUP function? What are its limitations and which alternatives can you use to overcome them? That's a classic. You can start like this. The arguments for VLOOKUP are lookup value, that's the value you're looking for, table array, this is the range of data where to look for your lookup value, column index number, the column number inside the lookup range that you want to return, range lookup. Here you decide if you want to return either an exact or approximate match. Now let's talk about its limitations. It can only look up from left to right. It can only find the first match. Approximate match is the default instead of exact match, which is a common cause for getting wrong results back. Generally, the column index number can cause problems because it's usually manually typed in. And then if you add columns in between your lookup range, you need to update that number. If you forget to do that, you're going to end up with wrong results. Better alternatives are index and match, and if you really want to impress in the interview, mention XLOOKUP, the brand new function in Office 365 that will replace all lookups. Number 2. How does absolute reference differ from relative cell reference? That one is commonly asked to check your understanding of writing formulas in Excel. Here's what you can say. Instead of hard coding values in a formula, we can use cell referencing to keep formulas dynamic. So for example, we can say equals A1 times B1 instead of saying equals 50 times 30. By default, Excel uses relative cell referencing. For example, if your formula references to A1 and you copy it one row down, it will be changed to A2. If you don't want that, you need to use absolute cell referencing. You can apply it to the row, column, or both. The dollar sign is an indication that an absolute cell reference is used. For example, if you fix both column and row by using $A, $1 and copy down one row, it will still reference to A1. What is a pivot table and when would you use it? With a pivot table, you can quickly summarize large quantities of data with different attributes. It's one of the most widely used features in Excel when it comes to data analysis. It's also simple to use because there are predefined functions like sum, count, and average to analyze data quickly and efficiently without us having to write any formulas. Each column in the data becomes a field in the pivot table, which can be dragged and dropped in rows and columns. It's a very flexible tool, and you can quickly create interactive reports to summarize, analyze, and present data. What is conditional formatting? Conditional formatting allows you to format a cell based on a logic. You can use it to automatically highlight important information on your report. And it goes beyond cell formatting. You can add in icons and data bars. There's some really good built-in logic that you can immediately apply, like highlighting the top 10%, or highlighting the values above average. But if you need to take it further, you can apply your own logic with your own formulas. When would you use the if function or a nested if in Excel? The if function is one of the most popular functions in Excel, and it allows you to make logical comparisons between a value and what you expect. It includes a test and two possible outcomes. The first result is if your comparison is true, the second if your comparison is false. So for example, if the condition is true, write OK, otherwise write not OK. When we have multiple conditions to meet, we can make use of the nested if function. That's an if function inside another if function. If you have Excel 2016 or above, you can use the ifs function, which can take the place of multiple nested if statements and is much easier to read with multiple conditions. So there you have it, my top 5 Excel interview questions. I hope this will be helpful when you prepare for your next job interview. And if you really want to make sure you have all the Excel knowledge to succeed in the workplace, check out my new course, Excel Essentials for the Real World. You'll start as a beginner and end as a professional. I'm going to switch over to the promo of the course so you have a better overview of what's inside. If you're curious, stay on. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next video. Learning Excel can do a lot for your career. You've probably noticed hiring managers are interested in your Microsoft Excel skills. But how do you know if your Excel knowledge is enough to be successful in the corporate world? That's what this course is about. Welcome to Excel Essentials for the Real World. I'm Leila. I'm a Microsoft Excel MVP, and for the last 5 years, I've been helping spreadsheet users advance their Excel skills and accelerate their career. Imagine making Excel do most of your hard work because of your ability to use the correct formula or the proper feature for the right task. Learning all of Excel's features and formulas is not what you'll be doing here. Instead, you're going to learn the important ones, and you're going to learn how to apply them to make your work easier. I've designed this course for two types of people: those who want to learn Excel from scratch, and those who want to make sure their Excel skills cover all the essentials, including many tricks and hidden features not many advanced users know of. As you're going to be working through the course, you're going to be able to showcase your new skills at work, and by the end of this course, you're going to feel confident and comfortable designing simple to complex spreadsheets. First, I'll take you step by step through the important aspects of working with Excel: inputting data, navigating large spreadsheets, and how to choose the correct formula to automate your analysis. You will also learn how to organize, clean, and manage large data, and create well-designed and organized Excel reports. You'll be able to turn messy data into helpful charts. You're going to create interactive reports with pivot tables and even import and transform data using tools like Power Query. Sign up today and you'll get dozens of practice workbooks, handy course notes to review important topics, challenges and quizzes to test and improve your knowledge, lifetime access, and a certificate of completion. Feel free to browse through the course topics. I'm really looking forward to helping you become confident in Excel and to get your work done faster.